I was forcefully taken out of the country by multiple police officers, all in violation of my due process rights, even though I had told them that I had an appeal pending. Nobody seemed to care. And I was threatened with force, physical force, possibly even the threat of death if I hadn't complied to their orders to go with the U.S. Federal Marshals. The worst moment that I can remember is one day a prosecutor looked at me and said, "My country cares nothing about me." So he is not worried about breaching the treaty. I felt so small. I have become more rounded, not as gullible as I was or trusting. I will start to believe in the justice system. After all, my father was a police officer. So I was judging the justice system and my father's character and the way he carried himself. This is my first experience dealing with with the justice system. So I was caught totally off guard. I trusted my attorney. I trusted the judge. I trusted even the prosecutor to go by the rules that I didn't know. When that district judge denied my motion, that U.S. magistrate denied my motion, I was the only one in court that didn't know that that magistrate lacked the jurisdiction to deny that. I'm past bitter. I'm embarrassed for these people who claim to be scholars, to claim to have integrity. Now let me tell you something, and this is honest. I have never dealt with a more corrupt set of people. I have used period, both places. I have dealt with the man in the street, both in Jamaica and in the United States. But their reputation precedes them. So in other words, if a person is not a trustworthy person on the street, somebody will inform you that that person is not to be trusted. And you have the option to avoid him. This is the first time I was entrusted on some people that I didn't choose to deal with. And I'm telling you, I've never dealt with a more corrupt set of people. I have been pursuing my due diligence claims since 1991 and to no avail. So I can honestly say that I've regained my liberty, but justice has still eluded me to this day. I have kids that have grown up into adults. I've been trying to get back as much quality time with these kids. What the governments did to me, I can't get that time back. But I'm going to make sure, and I'm going to be an advocate, not just for myself, but for everybody else, that what they did to me, they'll never, ever do to another person.